have done well, my apprentice. Delacon eliminated and Lord Rathori dispelled. This will be a day long remembered. The loss of Haladril Sitsun is unfortunate, but the ends far justify the means.
As long as you get what you want, the ends always justify the means, don't they?
Power depends on seeing the big picture. You have successfully eliminated both of my compromised agents. The time has come to set our sights on Noman Carr and his gifted Padawan. It seems our adversary is of like mind. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Noman Carr has been busy.
I wouldn't expect him to be complacent.
Good. Then you're less likely to be caught unaware. It appears your ship is being tracked. A very sophisticated sensor is reporting your every movement. I've traced the signal to a spaceport in a sector not far from you. I'm sure Noman Carr is involved.
It seems likely.
I've sent the coordinates to your mainframe. Head there immediately, dock with the station, and make a lasting impression.
Thank you. I have you covered.
So concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The time is upon you. I'm here. Say your piece.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
You're my master's sworn enemy.
Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
My quarrel is with you, Jedi. These men need not suffer.
Your temperance is remarkable. Hiroshio, please leave with your men immediately.
Thank you. Thank you, Master Carr. And you as well, Sith.
Don't mention it.
Now that they're safe, I'll speak plainly. I know Barriss has spies, and I know you were sent to extract two of them before they could be exposed. But I'll soon have the proof I need. Barriss's spies can't hide for long.
Call off your vendetta and I'll spare your life.
Jedi do not succumb to vendettas. That is for your kind. Forgive the earlier deception, Sith. But now that Hiroshio and his men have escaped harm, I must neutralize you immediately. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
I find that preposterous.
And you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in by any means necessary. It seems Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
No one else has to die. We can discuss this peacefully, Master Carr.
If only that were true. Until we meet again. apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
I doubt that Jedi will let her out of his sight.
You may be right, but as you close in on his prized pupil, he will be forced to deal with us. I am confident this is how we will prevail. The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish you cause will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
As you decree, my lord.
This will be a great test for you, apprentice. You have yet to face a Jedi master. Their righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating. And Noman Carr is no ordinary master. Confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
It will be an interesting experience.
Be sure your results are of interest to me. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her.
What does family mean to you? I mean, does it have to be the people you're actually related to?
When you're close to people, they become family. Sometimes, whether you want them to or not.
Cute. I'm going to take that as a compliment. When I was working for Noctrian, doing the pirate thief thing, he had a daughter my age, Risha. It wasn't like Noct was super sweet to her or anything. But he'd call her princess and I wished I was her.
Having someone your own age could be great or terrible, depending.
It was great. Always great. Risha was smart and strong. She knew how to do everything around the ship. And I went everywhere with her. Suddenly I had a sister again. For years it was Risha and me against the galaxy and anyone who gave us grief.
Memories of the best times in life are treasures later in life.
Who are you, and what did you do with the Sith I know? Eventually, Noct hatched some secret plan that I couldn't be a part of. One that apparently got them both killed. But for a while there, I really was happy. Enough of that.
My lord, I have been working on something in my spare time. You may be interested.
Go ahead, regale me.
Years ago, I was zeroing in on a notorious SIS agent called Volorin, when Moff Broisk recalled me to the Battle of Druckenwell. I had the spy cornered. I briefed Broisk so that he could send someone else to take Volorin out. He ignored the opportunity.
This sounds like a personal vendetta.
I'll admit, Knowing how close I was to ending his career made languishing on Balmoral all the more frustrating. But I take this on only for the good of the Empire. This spy has caused immeasurable losses. I know Vollerin's signature. And by tracking his accomplishments, I've picked up his scent.
It is imperative that you track him down.
Very good, my lord. I'll keep you abreast of my progress.
The sands of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Nomen Kaar brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
What do you hope to achieve by doing this?
Nomen Kaar shelters his prize, so we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves. My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste, but give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
The harsh sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharok Reeve. Our lord and master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yonlok.
I'm glad to have your assistance.
I will be your compass. You will find Master Yonlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
She brought the Force. It is a powerful weapon.
I have witnessed the power of the Force, but this goes beyond wonder. The Sand Demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch. I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing, its skin was glistening.
That is very confusing. Was it bleeding?
Not blood as from a wound. More like the layer of living gel one is born into the world covered in. What happened in that cave is a mystery. As is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabeau Jeef. He's as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
Tell me more about this man.
They say the planet talks to him. He predicts sandstorms and directs search parties to lost children. It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
I see no problem here.
Then I will meet you at Isabeau Jeef's hut.
Yeah. weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabeau.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
Ah, Sith. You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
Failure can be contagious, and hard to dispel once contracted. You are the Seeker Sharak spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
You see it correctly.
My eyes may be aged and failing, but my mind sees.
Please, Isabeau, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive Force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify. The sands speak of a ritual called the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharak witnessed was engaged in.
Explain this ritual.
The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh Sand Demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the Demon Slayer, the Savage Ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the Slayer seeks.
According to Sharak, the Padawan did not slay the beast.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood, but you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the Savage Ones speak.
I appreciate your help and insights.
Step lightly on my desert. It has been through so much in its life.
Here are the coordinates you will need. After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes.
I really don't have a good feeling about this.
Walking into a demon's lair, not your idea of fun?
Sorry, I just have an irrational aversion to attacking monsters that can swallow me whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the demon blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, Could we please get through this without mixing it up with the Sand Demon?
I was already planning on doing that.
Oh, good. That's a relief. Looks like it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up if it goes badly.
Desert, monster. I stand my ground. I will not run. Look into my eyes, beast. I show my back to demonstrate my dominance. The beast sleeps. Now, let us see what transpires.
Gross. This thing went to sleep and shed its skin. It's oozing blood and nastiness all over the place. And the smell. Oh, Cag, we're gonna stink for days. What if it never wears off?
It will be all right, Vet.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So, let's get out of the stink pit, huh?
You took the words out of my mouth.
Lead the way.
I trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The Sand People all ran from you. What transpired inside the Sand Demon cave that makes this so?
I mastered the demon without lifting a finger, and it shed its skin.
Remarkable. And you have bathed in the demon's essence. The Jedi Padawan must have done the same. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. There doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! On your guard, Offworlder. One of the Sand People approaches.
I will respond in kind.
I've never seen one of the Sand People approach an outsider in peace. This parchment the Sand Person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine and there is no such door.
If this is where the Padawan went, I must follow.
I shudder to think what awaits you there. The ravine marks the farthest I or anyone I know of has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed. Using the dune's shadows.
Think first of your own safety and do not follow if it becomes too harrowing.
Your concern is appreciated. Darth Barriss enlisted my services to be scout and lookout, and I intend to do my job. Head deeper into the desert, and you will find the Desert Wound Ravine. Safe journey.